and welcome to another edition of the Jungle News. I'm Avery Davis.
And I'm Aiden Estep.
A recent development of flash mob robberies have occurred throughout the United States, the most significant of which occurred in a California Nordstrom on the 22nd of November. The mob of around 80 members forced their way in with guns, crowbars, and other weapons in order to steal the store's high-end products.
Tens of thousands of protesters gathered in Australia's state of Victoria on December 4th. The protesters rallied against vaccine mandates and a pandemic bill that was passed by the upper and lower houses. The bill would give the state's health minister broad powers regarding lockdowns and mandates. Did you see Mr. Weibel at the choir recital?
The students seem to idle the new arrivals.
There's also Miss Bragg, who seems to have math in the bag.
Here's Tate Yoder with the scoop.
The West Liberty Salem administrators hired two new teachers in choir and math. They started in August before school started. The choir teacher position opened up after Mr. Henry left to go to Ball Fountain High School. The math opened up while Mrs. Spencer had part-time. For Mr. Weibel, this is his first time having his own classroom, but he sees other advantages being in the district.
We started with the marching band kids, gained some pretty good rapport with them, and I feel ultimately the staff, the parents, the students, they've all been very supportive and welcoming of me to West Liberty.
Mr. Weibel used to teach at Triad and was a middle school track coach. He teaches elementary, middle school, and high school choir. He is also the director of the show choir program. Last year, choir had Theory Thursday, and according to Catherine Hislong, that has been expanded to last year.
His teaching style is definitely different from Mr. Henry's, but I think it's definitely useful to have a different teaching style. We're definitely learning more music theory in our class, but we're still having a good time in choir.
The other new teacher, Mrs. Bragg, taught math in many private schools in Ohio. Her husband, Dan Bragg, is a WLS alumnus and was on the state champion cross-country team. She has four sons and seven grandkids. Mr. Johnson thinks Mrs. Bragg is a good fit.
Just really interacted well with our students and has a really, really strong math background. So knowing that about her when Mrs. Spencer was looking for a job share partner, Mrs. Bragg was the first person that came to mind.
Staff and students look forward for this upcoming year with new teachers. This is Tate Yoder reporting for the Jungle News.
Get your nap rag today.
Chloroform-filled nap rag will solve all your problems. Apply the rag to the mouth and watch the magic happen.
Side effects include headache, explosive diarrhea, vomiting, midnight munchies, severe comas, and death in 100% of patients that are bald.
The Grinch was arrested on November 26th after a brief pursuit in downtown Bell Fountain. He was then found guilty and charged for stealing Christmas cheer. The Grinch's punishment was being placed in a cage during Bell Fountain's Christmas parade. He was also forced to take photos with the locals as community service.
The WLS bowling team started their season at their home bowling alley, Southwest Bowl, in Urbana. The team has been playing matches and invitationals since November. These matches have made great practice for the team and will help them prepare for state.
Avery, you hold the key to my heart.
Aiden, I like you, but you're a little dorky.
Speaking of keys, here's Adam LaRock with a story on Key Clubs Fun Fridays.
The West Liberty Salem Key Club recently hosted the third Fun Friday of the 2021-2022 school year. Students gathered on the last Friday of every month for the event. At the latest Fun Friday, students played Ships and Sailors as well as Knockout. Sophomore Chaley Wade was the MC for the event, her first time doing so.
With being the MC, you have to be really good at keeping the crowd entertained and just being a good speaker in front of everyone because there's so many people. And so, yeah, just keeping the crowd going and keeping it fun for everyone.
Participants hit the deck, rode boats, and reenacted scenes from the Titanic. Only two remained. Freshman Quentin Rudolph, one of the winners of Ships and Sailors, enjoys the Fun Friday activities.
So it depends on the day. It depends how I feel. If I want to see some kids mess around or if I want to be the kid messing around. I don't know.
The Fun Friday subcommittee meets every week to ensure that the events run smoothly. Megan Adams, chair of the subcommittee, thinks last Fun Friday was the best one yet.
I think the energy level is pretty good. We definitely have a lot of school spirit, and it's showing this year for sure.
After the games, it was time to go back to class, but as students filed out of the gym, spirits were high. Fun Friday had done its job. The latest Fun Friday was a consensus favorite among students. This has been Adam LaRock reporting for the Jungle News.
WHIO Channel 7 filmed a segment of Seven Seas Your Town in West Liberty, Ohio on December 2nd. Crews filmed shots of Marie's Candies, Liberty Gathering Place, and LTU Uniquities to be featured in the television segment. The date the segment will air is to be announced.
West Liberty Salem senior Logan Saylor had his car robbed and vandalized while at an indoor adventure park in Dayton, Ohio on the 1st of November. Logan's car was stolen, used as a getaway vehicle, and stripped of all valuables. The unnamed suspect drove the car and crashed it after presumably getting in a shootout.
Hey, did you hear about the thing with Antonio Brown?
Oh, yeah, it was crazy. He ran right off the field.
Anyway, speaking of famous athletes, have you ever wondered what it's like to be Bella Kaufman? Here's Megan with a day in the life.
WLS senior Bella Kaufman is really making the most of her senior year through involvement in clubs and college-level classes, all while holding down a job. Having spent 12 years at West Liberty Salem has made Bella a prominent figure in the community. Bella is known for her sense of humor, moisturizing with shea butter, or as she calls it, shea butter, and one more thing, according to her best friend, Josie Kanaw.
I think her signature trait would be her bun that oddly resembles a biscuit from Popeyes.
Bella always keeps a positive outlook on life and is often found dancing through the halls. Rich Johnson has his own opinion on this matter.
You ever seen her dance? It was one day she was, I think it was at the softball field, or was doing something, and she just... I said, I didn't know Bella could get it like that. Yeah, she's good. Bella's all right. Bella's good. She could dance.
During the school day, Bella takes college-level classes, but evens out her schedule with electives as well. She stays involved through her participation in clubs such as Link Crew. According to Bella, her most difficult class this year is Mr. Linksweiler's College English.
It's pretty hard. You know, it's a lot of fun. He's a great guy, but... It's challenging, but I know it's preparing me for a very successful college future.
After school, Bella spends her evenings working at Michael's. This includes making and delivering pizzas. Bella may seem like the best employee there, yet her brother Silas thinks otherwise.
She's really mean, and she likes to boss everyone around.
While Bella's high school experience has been very memorable, she looks forward to the next 4 years at either Bowling Green State University or Ohio University. This has been Megan Adams reporting for the Jungle News.
Thank you for tuning in to another edition of the Jungle News. I'm Aiden.
And I'm Avery.
How'd you do on your exam last week?
I didn't take it, I just ate it.
You ate it?
Yes, I'll pass it sooner or later.
I'm Avery Davis.
And I'm Aiden Eastep.
And I'm Kanye West.
What?
Hey, did you hear about the thing with Antonio Brown?
Oh, are you ready?
I thought we were going. The students seem to idle the new arrivals. Avery, you hold the key to my heart.
Aiden, I like you, but you're a little dorky.
I'm so mad.